Good morning, fam, and congratulations for making it over the hump of Wednesday once again. This is Dr. Tommy Pringle coming to you again with another Work Week inspirational and encouraging message for today. On yesterday, we talked about how Christ didn't please himself, but he always aimed to please the Father in heaven. Christ took the disapprovals of the Father that caused disappointments unto himself, the disappointments of sinful acts by believers, the disappointments of believers deviating or straying away from the Word of God, and the disappointments of believers backsliding, just to name a few. Today we're going to continue on in the book of Romans in chapter 15 and pick up on verse number 4, where it reads, "For whatever was written in former days was written for our instruction, that through endurance and through encouragement of the Scriptures we might have hope." It's important to understand that even though Scriptures in the Bible were written over 2,000 years ago, they still apply to us today. Some like to say that the Bible was written to address the issues of those times, and we now live in new times where it doesn't apply. Well, I have news for you. Our God is omniscient, which means that he's all-knowing. So he knew over 2,000 years ago, after the life of Christ, loved us enough to provide us with instructions, guidelines, and promises to address what we're dealing with in today's time. Instructions on how to live, guidelines on how we should walk, and promises based on acceptance and obedience. The Scripture stated that through endurance, through the encouragement of the Scriptures, we might have hope. Endurance during times of sufferings for standing on the Word, during times of suffering for standing up for what is right, and during times of suffering for being willing to follow God's statutes instead of following the ways of man when you know that it may be immoral, unethical, or unlawful. That we might have hope. Allow that to resonate in your spirit today as the Lord continues to shape and mold you into the Christian that he called you to be. I love you with the love of the Lord. Be blessed this week.